from the grave. String band playing more, that honky tonk's pretty young thing going dancing in the rain. Hey darling, sleeping on the blacktop. Hey darling, running through the trees, honey. Hey darling, leaving for the next town, lesson my set sketches up with me. Hey darling, sleeping on the blacktop. Hey darling, running through the trees, honey. Hey darling, leaving for the next town, lesson my set sketches up with me.
So we just got in here last night and there was 6 pickups parked at the spot where we wanted to walk in. So we didn't end up walking in there this morning. We did kind of a drive around and like looked around the whole area, and we actually spotted a ram up here by himself. You know, and you could definitely see he had horn, but I mean, he's 4.5 miles away, so we couldn't tell if he was legal. But you know, we're quite a ways down the road from where the other entry was, so we're gonna hike in there and see if he's legal, and then if he's not, we're gonna loop up and around and check out some more mountains. So this is first day of me officially sheep hunting in Alaska as a resident, so it's exciting. Can't wait to get up there. So we've got in here and got a better look at that ram. He looked a lot bigger from two miles more away. He's still 2 miles away, but we can definitely tell that he's not legal. So, I don't know, there's four-wheelers everywhere in here, and I guess there was like 80 four-wheelers or 80 pickups with four-wheelers here opening day. So, I don't know, I just don't have a lot of faith in this spot, and I think I'm gonna move on and try somewhere else. But at least we were able to get in here and get a better look at him and know that he's not legal. And then this morning we had that other ram that we got a pretty good look at that also wasn't quite legal. He was a smaller ram, but he had a real tight curl, and I mean, he was at least 3/4, so we're in sheep. We just gotta pick the right spot, find the one that's legal, and go get him. So we're out here on the Plan C, which is basically just, you know, kind of driving the roads and learning the countryside. You know, I've been up here for a year, but I haven't got that much time to kind of get out and check out the country. So I'm in areas I've never been, glassing mountains I've never seen, and you know, we're finding sheep. And I mean, yeah, they're a long ways off the road, but you know, we found one that we found two actually in the same group that I think have potential to be legal. You know, one's a 3/4 curl that I think breaks the 8-year-old mark, and we got another one that's a little bit younger but got a tighter curl on his right side. So you know, it's just how it goes. You got to roll with the punches, but we're just gonna get in there tomorrow and get close and see what we can find. So hopefully they're legal, hopefully we get one down, and hopefully it doesn't pour down rain. So here we are hiking the jungle, and you know, from the road this looked like this was going to be a lot worse, really thick, and it's pretty thick, but really it's no worse than hunting elk in Idaho, you know. So we're just picking our way through here, making pretty good time, about 1.5 miles an hour, and we're about to get on another 1/2 mile, and then we hit the saddle that we gotta climb up and actually get in above alpine into the sheep country. So we're just picking our way through. It's definitely a jungle. So lots of moose sign, no bear sign or nothing, so that's really good. But I really wouldn't want to run into the moose either. With a piece in my hand,
bloodshot eyes, I walk to the water for a last goodbye. He begged so much, it clouded my mind. One thing's clear, the man's gotta die. Man makes right, so he said, when he yelled all the keys over our head. I lived in that grip, but now he'll learn at the end with the tables turned. Lord, forgive me. Take me on down the river where the guilt can't find a red-handed sinner. On where the grave can't cry out. 'Cause I done wrong down the river with a hand on a Colt and a finger on the trigger. And on before dawn they try to find me. So take me on down. Take me on down. Now there's blood and water filling up my lungs. Blood and water filling up my lungs. My heart is beating like a fading drum. Lord, forgive me, here I come. Take me on.
About 60 yards from the top, but we found how the sheep get their water.
Ridiculous. Damn things.
That's cool. That's amazing. That's why they never come down. Sixty more yards.
Thank you.
we don't have a lot of light, so we need to hurry up and get over there. And
something that's cool. Definitely once in a lifetime experience, your first round.
Thing is a beast. A freaking beast. And I knew coming up here that he wasn't a full curl. He's three-quarter curl. But I knew if we got close enough and I could count, make sure he was 8 years old and make sure he was legal, I was gonna shoot him. This thing is a freaking giant. This is so awesome. I never worked so hard for another animal in all my life. You know, and like, I'm nobody special. You know, I mean, this is a DIY, do it yourself in Alaska hunt, and anybody can do this. And I know, like, people are saying, oh, I can't just pick up and move to Alaska. Well, I mean, that just depends on how bad you want it. I mean, anybody, I came up a year and 3 days ago with intent of living the Alaska lifestyle and getting to shoot some crazy Alaskan animals, you know, and then getting to take this home and eat it, you know. I mean, this is just, this is surreal. You know, I mean, but my biggest thing is anybody can do this. Now, granted, you might want to hit the gym a little harder than I did, because holy crap, I got my butt kicked hiking in here today. Get in here. I can't thank Tyson enough. You know, this isn't a one-man show. Tyson came up here as a non-resident with zero sheep hunting experience, really.
Yeah, watch Derek shoot his first one last year,
I told him, I said I need somebody to go with. I need a cameraman, and mainly need someone that can just take the time off work. And said, you know, do you want to go experience a sheep hunt? And he was game. And about 2.5 hours ago, he was hating life, as was I. But
it's all worth it.
This is unbelievable. And to shoot such a freaking huge ram. I know. We expected this to be a day trip. We are about 12 miles from the pickup, and
12 miles of bushwhack.
With, well, 11 miles of just beating brush, and it is not going to be fun going out of here. And I don't think we're going to make it back to the truck, like, by morning. I think we're going to probably get down into these trees in the dark. I mean, it's going to be dark going off this mountain. We're gonna have to find a trail alpha here before we really open him up and get to work on him, just to figure out where we can get down. But yep. That's the sun rising. Still packing the sheep out. We took an hour and a half nap back up in the rocks. Got about halfway down the mountain last night. We still have to go through this drainage and go through that little saddle over there. And this is probably going to be the worst part of the whole hike because it's just brush that just grabs at your feet the whole time. So, not really looking forward to it. But it's the first time we've ever stayed out overnight without a tent or sleeping bag.
I don't recommend it.
We're kind of zombies this morning, but just chugging along, just keep chugging. Only like 11 more miles to go. Yeah, this is quite the jungle. These horns and my dang gun catch on every stupid branch all the way down this mountain, but we're moving. And the bugs on top of it. Not that I'm complaining or nothing. Man, I do got a sheep on my back. This is stop number 57, you know, but slow going through this jungle, but it's better to go slow, take it easy. You know, we're really not in any hurry other than maybe trying to beat some rain coming in tonight, but it's better to be slow and steady and not roll an ankle than, you know, try to hurry. So,
yep,
spirits are still high. Ish. Well, we made it to the truck.
We're alive.
We're at the next chapter of our hunt, and been driving around for a few days and finally found some sheep. You know, same thing, just driving around Alaska, glassing mountains and going to areas we've never been to before. And me and Justin finally found some sheep up on this mountain. Just kind of getting things situated to go after them. Probably gonna take a full day to get in, probably shoot them in the morning and hopefully be able to take a pack out. So we're just kind of getting situated, making sure everything's loaded. A couple days worth of food, which isn't too bad really. Pack should be light. We got good weather. You know, we have been watching the weather all week, and today and tomorrow, it's 10% chance of rain, which is the best it's been for a week. It's just been pouring. But then come Thursday, 3 days from now, it's going to be a half inch of rain. So excited. Go time. We've reached a solid knee-deep creek and haven't even walked a mile, so this is lovely. But we packed creek crossing shoes, so gonna get it done. I'm gonna film Justin walking across it first, so that when there's bloopers, I catch him on film. Of him, not of me, of course. Not of me. Plus then I can see how deep it is. How cold is it, Justin?
Probably 37.
Yeah? That's not bad.
stab a trout and show off my bow fishing skills.
You got wolf tracks inside of grizzly bear tracks. So, we are not the only predators in the forest.
Here you want a size comparison.
It's definitely a mature bear. I don't know about if I'd call it a giant, but man, it'd be pretty cool to see a bear and or a wolf. We have tags. Right there. We're getting to that zone where we kind of need to be quiet. And not make fast movements. These mosquitoes are driving me crazy. I'm gonna get cancer. But I ain't gonna have no mosquito bites. I see all of a 7/8 curl ram. I'm trying to make him a full curl.
How far away are we?
Oh, a mile. We're about 1,000 yards from him. And we're gonna go up this chute right here and then get kind of level with him. Because right now he looks like he's full curl, but we're below him looking up. So we wanna get on the same level as him so that when he does stand up, gives us a good profile, you know, we can 100% know that thing's legal. So
I'm gonna do the right thing. So we've been putting the time in behind the glass and just trying to make sure he's good.
This is exciting. He's the 8th ram we've seen in the last 3 days that's like borderline, you know. So this one's definitely got the most horn, and I think he's legal. We need to get up there and get in shooting position and then wait for him to stand up. So
there we go. You're almost there. 5,000 more feet.
Well, we got to where the sheep should be. And I think they've got up and they fed around the mountain. So
we have to get to that ridge line.
And they used to be right there. So We gotta get around that corner and see how far they've got. Got him, smoked him.
Oh. Justin, we killed the sheep. How do you feel? Isn't it cold up here? The wind's blowing.
Feel thankful. I feel like that went really well for as bad as it could have been.
We are in God's country. Like, the place these sheep live is unbelievable.
Him down. Oh, this is as good as it gets. What a day. Yeah, a one day hunt, and now gonna be a one day pack out, but legal ram down. First legal ram. Kicked out of the lesson one club. Congratulations, man. This is your sheep.
Thanks, buddy.
In God's country. We have so much work to do. I mean, it's cliche, everybody says it, but that sun's going down. The wind blows nonstop up here. Rain's on the way. It's going to be a long night, but it's so worth it. One day soon I will fly. I know I am free. I'm feeling alive. Take me back to the jungle. Take me back to the jungle. Blooper roll. My feet hurt. I'm so hungry, I think I'm gonna throw up. My back hurts.
Your feet, did you say your feet hurt?
My feet hurt. I see, you know, if you go into a public restroom, they got them silver bars on the side of the toilet. Those are for 29-year-olds like me. That's what them are for.